So I'm here with Linda Chavez-Thompson. You are a candidate for Lieutenant Governor of Texas.
Yes.
And I just wanted to speak briefly with you because of the media is spreading the rumors that things on the border states are really getting bad because undocumented immigrants crossing the border, bringing drugs, stealing people's property. What's the reality in Texas, for instance?
Those are scare tactics. They're just trying to scare people away from the border towns, and that is creating a financial burden on those cities. There is no violence in those cities. And it is a myth that's being perpetuated by the people who are against immigration reform. The Arizona law is a hateful law. It hurts people. They don't know that the people that are here because they're trying to reach the American dream. It is no different from all immigrants that have come to this country. And it's a shame that this is being used now as, oh my God, they're coming across the border. We already have enough protection on the border to deal with illegal guns, to deal with illegal drugs, but we cannot be scaring people away from the border towns of Texas or the border towns of Arizona, etc. We have to do something about it, and it's called comprehensive immigration reform legislation. We have to make sure that we blog about it, that we talk about it, that we make it an issue. Because it won't get done if everybody just sits back and lets somebody try to take care of the problem. We're the ones that have to do something about it, and we've got to do something now.
And you can speak from a personal perspective because you mentioned early on today at Netroots Nation that you work as a farm worker and your family did as well. Can you tell me a little bit of that experience?
My grandparents came here from Mexico. They were invited by the Federales to move out of Mexico because they were on the wrong side of the revolution. But when they came, they became citizens of this country, and they worked hard to provide for my father and, of course, my father to provide for us. I have been a farm worker. I have seen how people are treated. I have seen the disrespect. I have seen the hard work. And I've seen how people have built a life here in our country, just the same as immigrants who came from Poland or from Ireland or from wherever they came from. They were welcomed. They were made a part of the fabric of this country, but now they're targeting people who look like me. That's not fair. Just because somebody has a reasonable suspicion that I might have not be a documented citizen of this country is no reason to ask me. We have to do something about legislation, we've got to do it, and we've got to mobilize all of our folks to get it done.
There's a group of Americans, especially European descendants, whom they don't accept that this country is changing, the demographics, the cultures.
They're living, the folks who cannot accept that the demographics in this country are changing are living in another world. They've got to wake up, realize that it's here, it has to change, they must accept it. And if they can't, then they cannot say that they are true Americans, because that is not this country. We have to change it.
Absolutely. I was listening to your speech tonight, and I was tweeting that you have the courage and the honesty that is so much needed in this country, especially in politics. Where you get these values? I mean, you seem to be a very honest leader.
The values that I bring to who I am and what I'm all about are very simple. I was taught a work ethic by my parents. I believe, as so many others, that we need to build better lives for ourselves and for our children and our grandchildren. We don't have that today. As a candidate for Lieutenant Governor of Texas, I am making it my job to carry that message all over Texas, that it is time that we step up, it is time that we make the changes, and that we bring government back to the people of our state. I have lived 40 years of my life in the American labor movement. I've lived 65 years believing in the same thing, that I cannot stand for Texas to go through 16 more years against the workers of Texas, against education, against what I hold and believe so true. And I'm going to fight it. I'm going to try to win this position, and I'm going to be the voice for all working people in Texas.
And those are values shared by all peoples, all communities, regardless of race or origins.
I'm hoping that all people can believe the same way as I do, and I think if they do, they'll vote for me, and I'm hoping that they will.
Okay? Thank you so much,
Thank
Mrs.
So
Chavez.
Much. Thank you so much.